7 signs of diabetes at night. Did you know diabetes can have night symptoms that only happen at night? So pay attention to this video. What's the first sign of nighttime diabetes? I'll highlight nocturia here. What's that? You're waking up at night to pee. That didn't happen before. That's not your pattern. If you're like me, I get up 2-3 times to pee at night, sometimes more. But that's always been me. So I've looked into it. I'm not worried. Here, I'm talking about a pattern change. It wasn't like this before. And you've noticed that you're peeing at night. That's a warning sign. One of the main causes could be diabetes. When blood sugar is high, kidneys in their wisdom try to expel it. That makes your body pee more. So nocturia. If you're waking up to pee, and that wasn't the case. Number 2. This sign's interesting. It causes a lot of metabolic changes. Among these changes, higher blood sugar and conditions like high blood pressure. So really look at your sleep. If you're snoring a lot or wake up short of breath, you wake up feeling out of breath. It's not just a feeling. In this condition called sleep apnea, there's a drop in oxygen flow. It's called hypoxemia. That's when oxygen levels in the blood drop. This condition causes insulin resistance, one of the factors of type 2 diabetes, raising blood sugar levels. Both situations share a big risk factor, obesity, both type 2 diabetes and sleep apnea. It's important you ask someone else in the house, am I snoring a lot? If you're waking up feeling choky, short of breath, so keep an eye out. There are effective treatments for many disorders. It could be causing high blood pressure. Not only diabetes, but other situations too. And number 3, leg burning at night, because it could be a sign of diabetic neuropathy, diabetes' most common complication. Just know, to have diabetic neuropathy, blood sugar levels don't have to be very high. Even a mild change in blood sugar over time can cause neuropathy, the most common complication. So, leg burning you notice at night. Change in sensitivity can be another sign of diabetic neuropathy. Number 4, night sweats, hot flashes at night. You wake up with sweaty skin. You notice your pillows are wet. Your bed sheets, mattress, blanket are wet. Feeling of palpitation. You wake up with your heart beating faster. Nighttime tremors. Another thing with this is more nightmares. You didn't have nightmares. Now you're having them every night. These symptoms could be low blood sugar, specifically levels below 70. It's not exclusive to people diagnosed with diabetes using medication. This can happen even before being diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. For example, depending on your meal at night, a change might occur. A metabolic change leads to hypoglycemia. If you're already treating diabetes and use some medication and have the symptoms I explained in number 4, it's important. Take note of when you feel it and discuss with your doctor next visit. Nighttime hypoglycemia should never be tolerated. It's a dangerous sign because often, body gets used to the levels and you wake up feeling. Symptoms with lower levels, very dangerous for diabetics. So if it's happening frequently, notify your doctor and take note of all symptoms. Every time you feel it, and if possible, do a finger test, glucose monitor test, also called capillary glycemia. In some places, this test is also called fingertip test, HGT or dextro, but the main name, say, is capillary glycemia. So do the test and discuss with your doctor next visit if already treating either type 1 or type 2 diabetes. Signal number 5 is another curious one, restless leg syndrome. This signal, I won't explain what it is, as the name says, but these symptoms worsen at night, diabetes and high. Blood sugar levels also relate to increased restless leg syndrome frequency. Number 6. Before number 6, if you're here, please like this video, as it helps the system understand the video is relevant and shares the information with more people. Today's goal is 10,001 likes. Why? Because many people comment the goal is 10,000 likes. So I'll challenge you to make it 10,001. Number 6, you're waking up tired. You feel like you didn't get restful sleep, like you're already worn out. Tiredness is common symptoms in people diagnosed with diabetes. Despite high blood sugar, you can't use that sugar. Your body can't take this sugar and put it inside cells, muscles, because that's what insulin does. With type 1 diabetes and autoimmune disease, your body can't produce insulin. So that's why you feel that tired. And with type 2 diabetes, insulin resistance also makes that happen. If you're waking up tired, I'll never forget a patient saying, "It feels like I just ran a marathon." Number 7, a lot of thirst at night. Because during the day, you usually don't notice, you drink more. And why at night? But at night, it's quite noticeable. You wake up several times at night thirsty, because our body tries to balance it by drinking more. And at night, you notice this. These are 7 nighttime signs of diabetes. To wrap up, I know you'll ask about blood test values for diabetes or prediabetes. For fasting blood sugar test, the one you go in after at least 8 hours fasting, that test is normal till 99. So it's from 70 to 99. What about prediabetes range? Between 100 and 125. Diabetes is 126 or higher. Remember, for diabetes diagnosis, we need at least 2 repeats or a confirmed test like glycosylated hemoglobin. That is normal up to 5.6. From 5.7 to 6.4 is prediabetes. 6.5 or higher is diabetes. The third valid diabetes test is the one you do at the lab. You do the fasting test, take 75 grams of glucose, then take another sample after 2 hours.
So what are the results after 2 hours?
Normal value would be up to 140. A reading between 140 and 199 indicates prediabetes. Anything above 200 indicates diabetes. On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate this video? If it's 10, I'll make more of this kind. In what city are you watching this video? Where in the world are you from? I'm speaking from Porto Alegre. Now, I'd like to suggest a video where I discuss the 11 best foods for diabetes control. I'm sure you'll like it. Click here and find out what they are. Take care. See you.